Okay, this table shows assembly language instructions for the processor. Okay, and what the first instruction that has been shown here is the LDD instruction, which is used in direct addressing. So if this is our RAM and we get an instruction such as LDD3, this basically means, and this is used for direct addressing, this means that go to location number 3 in the RAM and fetch whatever value is in the location number 3 and load that value into the accumulator. So this value 57 is going to be loaded into the accumulator when this instruction is executed. This is direct addressing. Go to the location number 3 and fetch the value inside that location and load it into the accumulator. And then we have this load instruction, which uses indirect addressing. So what if we get an instruction like this, LDI4? This is an indirect addressing mode, right? So this instruction uses indirect addressing because this I indicates that this is indirect addressing. Okay, this means that go to location number 4. In location number 4, you'll find another address, and that address in our example is 16. Go to that address. So now we are going to go to address number 16, and now at this new address, whatever value is loaded inside this location, that is the value that has to be loaded into the accumulator. So this time, this value 24 is going to be loaded into the accumulator. This is indirect addressing, which means go to location number 4. There you'll find an address. Go to this address, and this is where you're going to find the value which has to be loaded into the accumulator. And the next load instruction that is given here uses indexed addressing. Okay, so if we get an instruction like indexed addressing, LDX15, which uses indexed addressing, just remember that indexed addressing would need to use the value inside the index register. So this IX is the index register which can be found inside the CPU. Okay, so how is the address going to be calculated this time? The address is going to be calculated by adding 15 to this value inside the index register. So our effective address is going to be 15 plus 2, which is going to be 17. So go to location number 17, and let's say we have a value 100 here, right? So go to location number 17 and load that value at location number 17 into the accumulator. So once again, in case of an indexed addressing instruction, the address is found by adding the value in the index register to the address value given in the instruction, right? So use 15, add 2 to it, find the new location, go to that location and load that value, fetch that value and load it into the accumulator. So this value is now going to become 100. This value in the accumulator is now going to become 100 because this value is going to be loaded into the accumulator. Okay, so there is another mode which is called the immediate addressing mode. So this load instruction is using the immediate addressing mode. This M here indicates that this is the immediate addressing mode. In the immediate addressing mode, you do not specify the address. Rather, what is written in the instruction is actually a value. So what you are saying here is that load this value into the accumulator. So this time 30 is going to be loaded into the accumulator. In case of immediate addressing, the instruction contains the data value that is to be loaded into the accumulator. And this hash sign is indicating, that this is a data value. Okay, this store instruction, when we get something like this, right? This is also using direct addressing, right? This is also using direct addressing, which basically means what? Which means that this is the address where we have to store the value. And which value has to be stored? The value inside the accumulator. So go to location number 1 and store the value inside the accumulator into that location. So store 88 into this location. Okay, the increment instruction. In the increment instruction, rather than specifying an address, up till now we've been given address values, right? The operand has always had address values. So the operand has always been addresses, right? Like we used LDD50. In this case, the operand was 50, which was an address. STO1, in this case, the operand was 1, which was an address, right? In this case, in case of an increment, the operand is the name of a register. So in this case, what if we get an instruction like this? Increment the accumulator. That basically means add 1 to the value that is already there in the accumulator. So the accumulator has a value of 88 and this should now become equal to 89, right? After incrementing, this will now become equal to 89 because we're going to add 1 to the value. Okay, what if we say, if we get an instruction which says increment the index register? So our index register already has a value of 2, and when we increment this, this becomes equal to 3. So this is going to become equal to 3. We're going to add 1 to the value that is already there in the index register. The jump instruction tells us which instruction to jump to next. So one of the registers inside the CPU is called the program counter, and the program counter tells us about the next instruction that has to be fetched. In this example, the program counter is telling us that the next instruction has to be fetched from memory location number 8 in the RAM. So program counter is telling us about the next instruction that has to be fetched into the processor. That instruction has to be fetched from location number 8 in the RAM. Okay. So what if we get a jump instruction which says jump to location number 18. This basically means that the next instruction that has to be fetched must be fetched from location number 18. So what this means is that the value of the program counter needs to be updated now, because the program counter is always going to tell us which is the next instruction that has to be fetched. When this instruction is executed, this instruction says that the next instruction that has to be fetched is going to be instruction located at location number 18, right? So don't look at the value inside the program counter, but the next instruction has to be fetched from location number 18. So when this instruction is executed, then this value in the jump instruction is updated into the program counter, which basically means what? Program counter was saying that you should fetch the next instruction from location number 8. So that is going to be overwritten now by this value. So program counter will now be updated to 18, which basically means that now the program counter is telling us that the next instruction that has to be fetched from location number 18. This is because we had a jump instruction that was executed. Okay, show the contents of the accumulator after execution of this instruction. After execution of LDD121. So LDD121 is using direct addressing. So this direct addressing means go to location number 121. Whatever value is in location number 121, load that value into the accumulator. So in the accumulator we have 0. We'll have 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So there's a box missing here, right? So this was the value that we've copied into the accumulator. Show the contents of the accumulator after execution of this instruction, LDI124. LDI124 is indirect addressing, which means first we are going to go to location number 124. At that location, we'll find an address value. So this is the address value, which is 0111 tetra 1. 0111 tetra 1. So let's calculate what this address value is. So this is 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, all the way up till 128. When we calculate this value after applying weights, it comes out to be 127. So this means go to location number. So when we are using LDI 124, that says go to location number 124. There you will find the address value. Go to this address value, and we've calculated this address value to be 127. So we are going to go to location number 127, and this is where we'll find the data value that has to be loaded into the accumulator. So this is the data value that has to be loaded into the accumulator. So that will be 0101001001. Explain how you arrived at your answer. Okay. The value at location 124 in the main memory is another address. So 0111 tetra 1 is equal to 127 in denary. This is the location from where data has to be loaded into the accumulator. So 127, this 127 is the location from where data has to be loaded into the accumulator. So that's our explanation. That's how we reached at our answer. Okay, show the contents of the accumulator after execution of this instruction. So this is using index addressing. In index addressing, this address is going to be added to the value held in the index register. So whatever value is present in the index register. So 120 is going to be added to this value, right? And this value equals 6, right? So this is equal to 6 in denary, right? So 120 plus 6 is going to give us 126. So in our accumulator, whatever value is lying in location number 126, so we have to go to location number 126. So this is the location, right? This is the location. Go to location number 126 and fetch the value, and fetch that value from there. So as we can see here, that at location number 126, this is the value that is stored: 0100001. So 0100001. This is the value that is stored at location number 126, right? So this is our answer. Explain how you've arrived at your answer. The operand value in the instruction was added to value in the instruction. To value in the index register. So this was added to value in the index register. That is, 120 was added to 6 to determine the location in the RAM from where the data had to be loaded into the accumulator. So that's the answer. Okay, and finally we have to trace this assembly language program into the trace table, right? Okay, the first instruction that is going to be executed is instruction number 300, right? And instruction number 300 says that load whatever value is at location 321. This is direct addressing, right? So go to location number 321 and load that value into the accumulator, which is 36, right? So 36 is going to be loaded into the accumulator. Once this instruction executes, 36, which is at location number 321, is going to be loaded into the accumulator. The next instruction that's going to be executed is 301, which says increment. And increment means that we are going to increment the accumulator, right? He has not specified the register here, but he should have specified that this was the accumulator, because we have no mention of the index register anywhere. So I'm assuming that this increment is for the accumulator. So he says that increment whatever value is in the accumulator, increment that. So in the accumulator we have this value. So when this instruction executes, 36 will be incremented to 37, and that value will once again be stored in the accumulator. Next is this instruction 302 at location 302. The instruction is store at location number 323. So go to location number 323 and store the value in the accumulator, which right now is 37, right? The most recent value is 37. So store this value 37 into location number 323. So we'll go to location number 323, and that is where we are going to store this value 37. So this is location number 323, right? And then this instruction gets executed, which is which uses indirect addressing. So this instruction is saying that go to location number 307. At 307, you'll find another address, and that address in this case is 320. So go to location number 320, and there you'll find the value which is going to be loaded into the accumulator. So this time 49 is going to be loaded into the accumulator. Remember, this was indirect addressing. So first we went to location number 307, right? At location number 307, we found another address which was 320. So then we came to location number 320. This was where the data value was stored. So we loaded 49 into the accumulator from location number 320. Okay, the next instruction that is going to be executed is instruction number 304, which says increment. So we are assuming that he is asking us to increment the accumulator, because he has not specified a register here. So we are assuming that he wants us to increment the accumulator. So 49 is going to be incremented to 50. That value is going to be stored in the accumulator. Next, this instruction will be executed, which says store into location number 322. So we are going to go to location number 322 and store the value that is already there in the accumulator at this location. So location number 322 would be this location, and this is where we are going to store the value in the accumulator, right? So we are going to store 50 here in the accumulator, right? That is how it is supposed to execute. So that's our answer. So once this is executed, the next instruction says end. So we are going to end our program, and we've completed the trace table. Hopefully you understand how this works.